In this talk, I will tell you about modified Euler's method for solution of swing equation. So we have already seen the Runge-Kutta method, and now we will take up the modified Euler's method. So as we were discussing, you know, we use numerical methods for solution of swing equation because it is nonlinear. And so modified Euler's method is also very simple to program, and hence it is quite popular. And you will know many of the things which I'll be talking in this class. We have already seen that. So modified Euler's method, similar to Runge-Kutta method, uses a truncated Taylor series expansion. And it uses only the first order term and discards all second order and higher order terms. So the computation is very simple and fast. So like in the other numerical methods, like Runge-Kutta and step-by-step method, we will be finding out the value of delta at the next time step from the knowledge of the value of delta at the current time step. So here the derivatives are used, and we will see what fashion they are manipulated to give us the value. So let us consider, like we did in Runge-Kutta, two general equations. I have dx by dt and dy by dt. So both are functions of x and y, and I have to solve for x and y with respect to time. That means I have to get the variable x and variable y with respect to time from the initial knowledge of x naught and y naught. Okay. So modified Euler uses the following equations. So we will take x naught, y naught and t naught as the beginning of a particular time step. And as before, we will take delta t as the time step and see what are the equations. So I have to find out first, what do I have to do? I have to find out dx and dy. Dx is dx by dt, derivative of x with respect to t and derivative of y with respect to t. And I will be, we saw both are functions of x, y and t. So I will be finding it out using values x naught, y naught and t naught. And these are called as, you know, it is denoted this way, dx by dt 0. That means using the initial values. And this is called as dy by dt using zeros. So that means I start off with an initial set of values of x naught and y naught at time t naught. And using these values, I compute dx and dy. Okay. Now, we have an intermediate prediction in modified Euler's. So I predict xp, p stands for prediction, is equal to x naught, my initial value, plus dx into delta t, which will give me the change in x. Remember, dx is dx by dt. So if I multiply it by delta t, it will give me the incremental change in x. Similarly, I also find out yp, which is incremental change taking into account the incremental change in y. So yp, the predicted value of y, is y naught plus dy dt. Okay. So this forms the first step of modified Euler's method. Next, what I do, again I calculate dx and dy using these predicted values and the updated value of time. Okay, so I find out dxp, it's the suffix p is given here to show it's using the predicted values. I find out dx by dt p. What is that? I evaluate the function fx using xp, yp and t1. If it's not a function of time, it can only be a function of x and y. Similarly, I find the derivative dy by dt of the using the predicted values, and it's denoted as dyp. Right? So this is the intermediate values. Then I update the values of x and y as follows. X is x naught plus the average of dx and dp into the time delta t, and y1 is y0 plus dy plus dy p by 2 into delta t. Okay, so just let me take you through the procedure once again. You have to start off with the initial values of x0 and y0 at a time t0. Okay, then using this values, using x0 and y0, compute the derivative dx and the derivative dy. Then using this, calculate the intermediate predicted values of x and y denoted by xp and yp. Next, find the updated derivatives using these predicted values. So that we call it as dxp and dyp. And then x1 is x0 plus the average of the two derivatives multiplied by delta t. And y1 is y0 plus the average of the two derivatives multiplied by delta t. Okay, so taking this average improves the accuracy of the method. Okay, that's why it's called as modified Euler's. In Euler's method, this intermediate values are not calculated. This itself, what I have shown as the predicted value itself is taken as the value in the next time step. So this is a modified version where I have an intermediate time computation. Now let's come back to our swing equation. How do I apply? So as before, we know the swing equation is given by md squared delta by dt squared is equal to pa, or d squared delta by dt squared is equal to pa by m. We have used this in the other two methods. And just like in Runge-Kutta method, here too, I write the swing equation. It's a second order differential equation. I write it as two first order differential equations. So d delta by dt is equal to omega. That's the first equation. And d squared delta by dt squared will be d omega by dt. That is equal to, we have seen, pa by m. Pa is the accelerating power. And pa is equal to pm minus p max sine delta by m. So these are the two first order differential equations. And what are my two variables corresponding to x and y general equations? One is delta and other is omega. So to start, what do I need? I need the value of delta naught and I need the value of omega naught. Okay. And like in the other methods, you have to use the correct value of P max depending on whether you're doing before fault, during fault or after fault. So now let us see the modified Euler's equations for this. So I start with initial values delta naught, omega naught and t naught, and take a time step of delta t seconds. The two variables, as I told, are delta and omega. So what do I do? First, I find out, I've just given a name, d1 and d2 to represent variables 1 and 2. Variable 1 is delta and variable 2 is omega. So d delta by dt naught is equal to d1, and d delta by dt is omega. So it is equal to omega naught. And d omega by dt, remember, is pa by m. Pa is pm minus p max sine delta. So I use delta naught here by m. So this is the first calculation I do, d1 and d2. Okay. This is corresponding to your dx and dy in the general equations. Next, what do? I update the intermediate values, predicted values. So delta p is delta naught plus d1 into delta t. And omega p is omega naught plus d2 into delta t. Right? So these are my intermediate predicted values of delta and omega. Then what did we do? We again calculated the derivatives using that. So d delta by dt is, I have denoted as d1p, is equal to omega p. Okay? Because d delta by dt is omega. So it's omega p. And d omega by dt is pm minus p max sine delta. What is the delta I have to use? I have to use the intermediate value, delta p by m. Right? So I have calculated the four derivatives, just like how I showed you with x and y. Next, update the values of delta and omega. Delta 1 will be delta naught, the old value, plus average of the two derivatives, that is d1 plus d1p by 2 into delta t. And omega 1 will be omega naught plus d2 plus d2 p by 2 into delta t. Clear? So now what are these values of delta 1 and omega 1? These are the values of delta and omega at a time step t plus delta t. T plus delta t. Okay? Next, what I do? I use these values of delta 1 and omega 1 to calculate delta 2 and omega 2. So in a program, what you would do is, now you would equate this delta 1 and omega 1 to delta naught and omega naught and go back and calculate these values. Do it again and again, again and again. So you see here, the occurrence of a fault is fine. When the fault occurs, I just use the correct value of P max. Okay? So this is modified Euler's, very simple to compute. And in the next lecture, I will show you an example for the computation. Thank you.